embroidery. So this is something I've been learning about lately. Sewing with thread, I've had the chance to make use of machines that do this automatically. My partner has a machine, and we're learning how to use PEmbroider. That is a library from Golan Levin and other collaborators that you can generate embroidery files from processing. These are tests that I have been doing there, just trying to generate a weird path with which you can sew or embroider your clothing. So this is one example, and then croquetilla. So this is another example, another illustration that we have been testing. So with this, you can customize your clothing, your textiles, or other things. Here's another video. This is just an outline. Yeah, and this is just an image of those things. All right, so these I showed because we might be seeing some of that code in the future. I don't really know if that's of interest to people, so just let me know if this is of interest, but I'm definitely a maker. I want to keep learning about this, and I'll be showing more stuff in the near future. This is PEmbroider by Creative Enquiry. I want to thank everyone who contributed to this. It seems like it's these four amazing people so far that we have here. And what they've built is a library that is open source and allows you to do a lot of stuff, even customize patterns and build your own vector fields in a way that you can fill in shapes and stuff, and then generate paths that will work with your design. So you can embroider your clothing or textiles, as I mentioned before. Okay, so let me just take a look here so you can get a grasp of some of the examples and the cheat sheet pieces of code of the things that you can do. If I open processing here, we're going to see an example. And the other thing I wanted to show is their example. So there is a really illustrative list of example files that they ship with the library with the code to produce all of these things, which I think it's amazing. So they have many possibilities. Some of the things I was trying look a bit like this circle, like this one. And I have a lot of stuff to test so far. But what I really like is that they have custom tools to create paths. So this is embroidering paths from vector information, such as loading SVG drawings and loading them in different ways. So maybe the outlines or infills and stuff. And also, like you can see here, so we're inputting a PNG, I think, so black and white map. And it detects that all the white things probably are vectorized or something. And then they have different patterns to infill these graphics. And it's pretty powerful. And then the last part of the story is that they also give you this application that they say is great for kids, so no coding required. You can generate embroidery paths with your mouse just clicking as a drawing app, like a paint app to develop embroidering files. This is, I would say, it's really cool. It's none of the files that I showed before. Still, you can get a hint on what this is here. So this, by zooming even a little bit more, those pink points are the points where the needle will enter the textile and make a point on the, a path on the drawing. So you can get an idea, like here in this one, for instance, you'll get like a pattern like really dense, while some others will be a lot less dense, like this one. So yeah, this is PEmbroider. I would like to see more of it in the future. If you're interested, let me know. We can take a look at that. That was Nono Martinez Alonso. If you enjoy this content and this is the type of videos that you would like to see more of, click ahead and like the video. And subscribing is useful if you want to get notified when I upload new videos or when I go live. You can join us on the Discord community at nono.mas/discord. I would like to thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.